Bianca, can you come up here real quick?
我来叫我们的这位小的姐妹。
Okay,
果果来一下。
Look at this girl. Look at her.
请大家看一下我们可爱的姐妹果果。
Look at how pretty she is.
美丽的小女孩。
Look at how sweet she looks.
很这么看起来这么甜蜜甜美的一个。
She's kind of innocent looking.
她是不是看起来很单纯很可爱的一个小女孩。
How can this be a murderer?
她怎么可能是神说她害命呢?
How can this be a killer?
怎么可能呢?
So there's this disconnect. Thank you, Bianca. You murderer.
谢谢你来给我们愿意做这个表演。谢谢你。
But there's a disconnect. You know, it's hard for us to imagine why God would accuse us that way.
这样我们看到这个标题的时候，我们有这么大的一个偏差，我们很难想象说为什么神说我是害命的。
And if that is true, what does it have on our daily lives? How does that impact how we live?
但是如果这个真的是神所说的是这个真理的话，那么我们每天的生活应该对我们有什么样的意义呢？
If it was legit in this world, we would have gone to jail, right, for murdering someone.
如果是在今天的法律上的话，你如果杀人的话是要进监牢的。
Yeah, so to seek the answer to this question, we're going to look at a non-traditional Easter passage.
那么今天我们来所讲的这一段经文是出自一段一般来说并不是很经常在复活节讲的一段。
Because if I'm being accused of something, I want to know if that's true or not.
那么如果神是这样子说我害命的话我要得到一个那个晓得这个到底是怎么一回事
And more importantly, if I find that to be true, what can I do about it?
而且更重要的是如果一旦我发现这个是真理的话那么我应该怎么样去做呢
All right, so we're going to look at Mark chapter 3 verse 1 through 6 this morning.
我们今天的经文是在马可福音三章一到五节里面。
Chronologically, can't even say that word. From the time, if you look at a time period, it's before Jesus' death and resurrection.
这段的发生的时间是在耶稣上十字架和复活之前发生的。
But through this passage, we can see how God saves lives and how I kill lives.
但是从这段经文里面，我们可以看到为什么是神救人救命。我害命。
All right, so I'm going to have it projected on the wall, and what I'm going to do is ask Winnie to read it in Chinese. And for those that are English readers, you just read it, okay? I'm not going to read it.
我们把这段经文放在打字这个上面，请那个我来读中文。耶稣，马可福音三章一到六节，耶稣又进了会堂，在那里有一个人枯干了一只手，众人窥探耶稣，在耶稣安息日。医治不医治，意思是要控告耶稣。耶稣对那枯干一只手的人说：“起来，站在当中。”又问众人说：“在安息日行善行恶，救命害命，哪样是可以的呢？”他们都不作声。耶稣怒目周围看他们，忧愁他们的心刚硬，就对那人说：“伸出手来。”他把手一伸，手就复了原。法利赛人出去，同西利狱党的人商议，怎样可以除灭耶稣。
All right, thank you, Winnie. So the Pharisees that were mentioned in this passage, they're kind of like the pastors today.
我们在这段里面看到的这些法利赛人，就好像是今天的牧师。
They're supposed to be the people who are godliest.
他们本应是最属灵的。
They're supposed to be the people who love the neighbors the most.
他们也本应是最爱人的那些。
They're supposed to be the one who leads other people to God.
他们本应是带人来到神的面前的那些人。
But what are they planning in this passage?
可是我们却看到他们在这一段经文里面在做的是什么事情呢?
They're planning to kill Jesus.
他们是在商议怎样灭除、除灭。
An innocent man.
耶稣是一个完全无罪的。
Can you picture this?
你可以想象这样的画面吗?
So picture me plotting to kill someone else.
就在你们脑海里面可以想象说我这个牧师是今天要在谋害想除灭什么人吗?
Picture Pastor Meng trying to murder someone right there.
可以想象那个孟牧师是不是在怎么样用计来除灭什么人。
Picture Elder Perry sitting right beside Pastor Meng, plotting to kill someone. Oh, he's in his wife.
或者是 Perry 长老，然后他就很配合的拍了拍他的妻子的头，好像要杀他的样子。
Elder Peter right here.
还有小东长老。
Does he look like a murderer to you?
我们大家，你的脑海里能够想象他是一个杀人犯吗？
It's hard to imagine, but that's what this passage is saying.
可是当时的法利赛人在这章里就讲到，他们是在设计除灭耶稣。
And so I want to show us why this accusation is correct, and I want to talk to us about the bad news first.
所以这一段就是我想跟大家讲，为什么我们是害命的。
This is what this passage is getting at, is that we have a hard, murderous heart.And that's bad news.
这里面有一个很坏的消息，就是我们每个人都有一个很刚硬的害命的心肠。
All right, don't believe me. You guys don't believe me. We'll do a small test.
我们如果你不相信我的话，我们再来做一个小的测试。
Okay, we're going to do another poll. Okay.
我问大家一个问题。
If you have ever hated someone, raise your hand.
你是否曾经恨过某一
个人？
请你举
手。Only half.I'm sure more than half have hated other people. Okay, I'm gonna be the first to say I have hated people.
我自己就承认说我是恨过恨恶人的。
So I'm definitely guilty of it.
我是在这方面的确是有这个发生在这个事情上。
This is what Scripture says from 1 John 3:15.
在约翰一书的三章十五节里面这样讲。
All right, so I'll read it out to you, and then Winnie will read later. Anyone who hates a brother or sister is a murderer, and you know that no murderer has eternal life residing in him.
凡恨他弟兄的，就是杀人的。你们晓得，凡杀人的，没有永生存在他里面。
So by this definition of God, I am a murderer.
当我们看到这个神的定义在这章里面写的，那么我就是一个杀人的。
And we have murderers sitting in here this morning.
我们今天大家在座的话，很多都是这样的杀人犯。
Yeah. Look to your left, look to your right.
在坐在你的左右的，就是。
Yeah, murderers. And I will confess, over the course of our marriage, I have murdered this beautiful lady here several times in our marriage.
就算在我自己的婚姻中，我也曾多次的想要杀死我的妻子，或者以前想，想。
No, hate, not kill. Okay, I've never plotted to kill my wife. Okay.
很多次的恨过她。
Yes, hate.
还没杀成。
And that was early in my marriage. Early in my marriage.
是在我们婚姻就是前面的。
Yeah, not recently in the last few weeks.
最近这两个星期还不错。
So that's one bad news. Here's another one that Sister Helen actually called out.
这个是第一个这个所谓的坏消息哈。刚才那个黄河姐妹也说到，另外一个坏消息是什么呢？
And the second bad news is what Easter is all about.
那么这个第二个就指向我们这个复活节的这个信息。
It points to another person that we have murdered.
复活节就是向我们指出我们另外一个曾经杀害的这个生命。
Because of our sins, we have murdered Jesus Christ.
因为我们的罪，他就是耶稣基督钉死在十字架上。
So let me read this passage from Romans 5:8.
罗马书五章八节这么说。
But God demonstrates His own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
唯有基督在我们还做罪人的时候为我们死，神的爱就在此向我们显明了。
And Scripture says every single one of us are a sinner.
神的话语就是这样告诉我们，我们每个人都是罪人。
It's something that we were unfortunately born into.
我们与生以下来就有这样的罪的。
When God first created all of creation, it was all beautiful and perfect.
当神在最初创造一切的时候都是美好的。
But when he created the first man and the first woman, they sinned against God by disobeying.
当神创造亚当夏娃，他们犯罪了之后，他们就背逆了神。
And so as a result, all generations after that, every one of us included, have been tainted by sin.
因为他们的罪，我们万世万代的这个人都有这样的罪性。
And so by God's definition this morning, I have again murdered Jesus Christ.
因为这个的定义，我们大家也看到，因为我的罪，我也是害了耶稣基督的命。
If I wasn't a sinner, Jesus wouldn't have to die for us.
如果不是我是罪人的关系的话，耶稣基督不需要为我们舍命。
And so this has tremendous implications to our daily lives.
而这个对我们每天的生活是有很大的意义的。
Sin causes to have a very hard heart.
因为罪的关系，我们的心是刚硬的。
And we saw that in the passage earlier with the Pharisees. They had a tremendously hard heart.
刚才我们第一段圣经里也看到法利赛人他们的心肠就是这样的刚硬。
Sin and hardness robs us of freedom in Christ.
因为罪和这个我们刚硬的这个心肠，我们他就把我们夺去了我们能在神里面享受我们这样的自由的这种权柄。
It robs us of goodness, of joy, of love.
就因为这样，我们也不能享受在神里面所能够得到的平安和喜乐。
It robs us of being a life giver to others around us.
因为罪的关系，我们也不能将生命赐给周围的人。
And so that's terrible news.
这是一个非常糟糕的走向对堕落的消息。
Our hard, murderous heart.
我们的心肠是这样的，不但是毁坏的，而且是害命的心肠。
All right, hopefully by now you're all convinced that you are a murderer.
我想你们现在大家可以看到承认了吧，我们是害命的这样的人。
So what's the solution here, God? I don't want to be stuck being labeled as a murderer.
那么神给我们开了一个怎么样的路呢？
There is good news in this.
那么这就是我们的福音好消息了。
And so this is what I want to unpack for us. That the good news is that Jesus' resurrection gives us a new heart.
而这个好消息就是因为耶稣的复活给了我们一个重造的新造的心。
And if you will remember in the passage, Jesus was angry when the Pharisees wanted to kill him. He was angered, he was distressed by their hard hearts.
当时在马可福音刚才我们读到那一章就看到耶稣当时他虽然他既是很愤怒的看这些法利赛人，他也是很忧愁的。
But here's the amazing thing about Jesus Christ, that he still died for them.
虽然他是很愤怒和忧愁的，他却还是为这些法利赛人也上到了十字架上。
How many of us would die for someone who's trying to kill us?
我们哪一个人是愿意为想要害我们的那个人，想要杀死我们那个人，去舍命呢？
I would say nobody.
我想没有人是愿意这样做的。
But that's the amazing grace of Jesus Christ.
这就是神的奇妙恩典。
And I want to show us two passages that talks about this.
我们在下面看两段经文来讲这个真理。
From 1 Peter 1:3, it says, "Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead."
彼得前书一章三节，愿颂赞归于我们主耶稣基督的父神，他曾照自己的大怜悯，即耶稣基督从死里复活，重生了我们，叫我们有活泼的盼望。
See, something fundamentally changed when Jesus was resurrected.
我们看到当神复活的时候，就从根本上有一个非常大的一个转变。
It tells us a new birth has started.
我们看到一个重生的一个生命开始了。
It gives us the idea that we're getting new body parts.
它让我们看到说，我们的身体上的器官，我们身体的每一部分都可以更新了。
And I want to look at an Old Testament passage that God tells us a very specific part that He's switching out for us.
我们看一下旧约啊，有一段特别的讲到我们身上的这个器官重新被更新。
This is from Ezekiel 11:19.
以西结书十一章十九节这么说。
I will give them an undivided heart and put a new spirit in them. I will remove from them their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh.
我要使他们有合一的心，也要将心灵放在他们里面，又从他们肉体中除掉实心。
And I'll give a testimony to this that this is true in my life.
我自己的有一些亲身经历就可以验证这是一个真理。
You know, I was joking about murdering my wife early on in our marriage, and that is very true.
刚才我曾经讲到，在我的婚姻的前期，我真的是很对我的妻子有这种恨的感觉。
There are many things I didn't want to. Actually, there were many things I wanted to do to her.
我甚至想对付对付她。
And I did.
我的确是做了一两件这样的事情。
And I'm kind of ashamed to acknowledge that.
今天我在跟大家分享，我也觉得挺丢脸的哈。
But here's my excuse.
但是我有一个借口，我今天可以这么说。
The first couple years of our marriage, I wasn't a Christian.
我的借口就是说，我刚结婚那前两年的话，我并不是一个基督徒。
I had a really hard heart.
我的心是那个刚硬的，实心。
And when I came to know about the love of Christ, this passage came to be true. He switched out my heart.
当我认识了基督耶稣的时候，这一段经文就真正的是发生在我的身上了，就是实心被换掉了。
On days where I feel like I have a good reason to hate my wife, God softens that heart and say, "You need to love her and forgive her instead of yelling at her and not talking to her."
当这个事情发生的时候，虽然有些我妻子做了一些事情让我非常的讨厌愤恨，但是神就是让我有一个爱心，用这个柔软的心去爱他。
And these folks right here, those who are getting baptized, they're going through the same journey.
今天我们也看到我们在第一排有几位弟兄姊妹，他们将受洗，他们的生命也是这样的。
They're going through this journey where God's promise is going to come true in their lives.
他们也走过这样的一个旅程，神的新的生命会在他们的身上。
The hardness of their heart, God says, I'm going to give them a brand new heart, a heart that's flesh and tender.
在神的应许就是说，要将他们心里的这个刚硬的实心转换成一个温柔的一个肉心。
And so now their daily living isn't bound by the bondage of sin and heart hardness, but in the tender hardness of a new heart from God.
这样的话，他们的生命就不是在这个实心和这个罪的捆绑之下，而是在主的这个新的温柔的心里面的释放。
If you remember the question that Jesus asked in the beginning of the passage in Mark, he says, "Should you do evil or do good?"
我们在想回想马可福音第三章，耶稣是怎么问众人的？他说：“你是行善行恶，救命害命，哪样呢？”
And so for these folks right here, evilness will no longer define their lives.But goodness.
而这些我们要接受受洗的这些弟兄姊妹，他们这个所谓的恶已经不能够来形容他们的作为了行为了。
Killing and murder no longer defines their life, but now they are going to be life givers.
他们的生命也不是那个害命的那样恨的生命，而是能够传递生命、传扬生命的一种生命。
Man, isn't that good news?
我们想一下的话，啊，这是一个多么美好的好消息。
That's excellent news for all of us.
这简直对我们来说太棒了。
So I want to end with some practical things that we can try out this week.
这一周的话，我想我们在结束之前，我给大家几个我们可以去试着去行的。
So all of you should have this in your bulletin. If you don't have it, raise your hand and the usher will pass it out. But it's an article.Called the early warning signs of a hard heart.
大家在你拿到的这个单张里面应该有一个夹页， 如果你没有的话，请你举手，后面的会给你一份哈。
Okay, so
他这个文章是讲到我们这个心灵的刚硬有什么一些表象，有一些预兆哈。
All right, so don't get distracted reading it right now. I'm going to give you a highlight. You can read it when you go home today.
现在不用一行一行开始读，我想给大家几个很快的一个要点。
So they have about 10 points here, and I'm just going to talk about four that I normally encounter when I'm talking to folks at church, four that I encounter in my personal life, and so I want to highlight these.
这个有四点的话，这个征兆我自己个人有经历，所以我希望跟大家分享。
So the first part it was asking is, what are some early warning signs of a hard heart? And I want to talk about two of them.
第一段是说到底有什么标示表这个征兆呢，怎么能就知道你的心是刚硬的呢，有两条哈。
Alright, so the first one is you don't really celebrate and you don't really cry.
就是如果你已经根本就不愿意去为什么事情所庆祝，也没有说什么事情值得你去哭泣的话，恐怕你心硬了。
If you think about it, when was the last time you actually celebrated something?
请你回想一下，最近上一次你为什么事情真的是用心的去庆祝呢？那是什么时候
？If you can't think of any, that's an early warning sign that you have a hard heart.
如果你真是想也想不出来的话，恐怕你最近的心有一点硬了哈。
So what can we do about this?
那么我们怎么办呢
？Celebrate.
那我们今天又来庆祝。
Alright, we're celebrating Easter. That's one reason we are celebrating today.
今天我们就是在这里一起来享受和欢庆主的复活。
And the challenge for you this week, if you're willing to take it on and start working away at that hard heart, is to find one reason to celebrate.
那么这一周的话，我也希望鼓励大家，如果你觉得你的心有一点点硬了，有点无所谓的话，请你为一件事情。去好好的庆祝一下。
Maybe someone around you is having a birthday and you make them a cake.
也许有人生日哈，你可以帮他做个蛋糕之类的。
Maybe some people just got baptized and you want to give them a gift.
也许这几位受洗的，你想对他们有一种表示，给他们一些礼物庆祝。
There are so many things every day that we can celebrate.
实际上每天的话，我们的生活中有很多可以感恩让我们庆祝的事情。
God calls us to a life of praise and thanksgiving.
那么神也是让我们的人生是充满了这样的感恩和欢庆的。
All right, so that will help you go away from a hard heart.
那我想这是一个让你从这个刚硬的这种心灵的状态中脱离的一个办法。
All right, here's one more. You no longer believe in the best about people.
另外这一点我自己有体会的就是你再也不太想到这个每个人都有他一个好的那一面哈。
Whenever you talk to a person, the first thing you see is what's wrong with that person.
可能我们现在经常看任何人都想的就是这个人怎么那么多毛病啊。
That's an early warning sign of a hard heart.
这是一个表证，是你的心很刚硬的一种表证。
So what do you do about this?
那么我们怎么做呢？
When you see someone, the first thing you ought to be thinking about is what is good about this person.
那么我希望大家看到另外一个人，任何一个人的时候，第一个想的事情是他的好的一面是什么。
What has God gifted this person with?
神怎么样来祝福这个人，有给他一个什么天分，一个礼物。
There's always something good that you can celebrate about that person.
肯定有任何每个人肯定都有他非常美好神所给予他的一面。
And so maybe that's you, and that could be your homework this week.
这个我是有体会的，那也许你自己也有这方面的问题，那么希望这周你就来家庭作业就是这一项哈。
Right, so the next question, and this is where we're going to wrap up, is how does it happen? How does our heart start getting hard?
我想在他下面这段是讲的是什么呢？我们怎么会变成这样？是有一些原因的。
And there's two that I've seen a lot, and especially with the youth retreat that we came back from a couple weeks ago, a lot of the youth confessed this particular point.
有两条的话，我们最近也是在那个 青少年的这次退休会回来的话，有很多孩子也跟我们分享他们自己在这两方面，我发现有一些就是他们的原因哈。
So the first one is you overprotect a broken heart.
第一个就是我们自己的话，就是把自己的一颗心把它保护住，太过分的去保护这个。
It actually breaks my heart to see all the young people, you know, this young in their life, that they've been broken so many times that they're protecting it.
这个也是让我非常有感触和伤心的一点。虽然我们的孩子这么小，但是就发现他们似乎已经受了很多次伤，要用各种方式来保护自己。
They've stopped trusting, they've stopped loving, they've stopped believing.
因为这样的伤害，他们就不愿意对人给予任何的信任，给予任何的爱。
And believing.
和相信别人。
And so they just protect it. If you protect your heart, then you'll never get broken.
对啊，所以他们就要把自己保护起来。这样的话，我如果不把我的心灵敞开，那当然我也就不会受伤害了。
And the weird thing is, you get the opposite effect. Your heart becomes harder and harder.
可是我们却发现，当你这样做，以为是保护自己的心灵的时候，反而是越来越刚硬，越来越悖逆。
And here's the last one. You accept a harder heart as a new normal.
那么最后这一点的话，也有很有体会的，就是最后我们把我们这个心灵的这种刚硬，反而变成了我就是这个样子的一个常态。
And so you live every day with a harder heart, and that becomes your new normal for tomorrow.
我们每天就这样的刚硬的话，渐渐的似乎这成一个习惯，明天我也是这样去做的。
And then you just tell yourself, well, that's just how I am. That's my condition of my heart now, and I've accepted it is a hard heart.
而你自己也告诉自己说，我就是这样的，我的心肠是比较硬的，这是我的个性。
The way to get around it is to get your heart into God's word.
那么我们神让我们回转的方式就是回到他的话语里面去。
Because God is the only one that can swap out that heart.
我们刚才看到那段经文就是说，只有神才能把我们这个实心所除掉。
And so if you don't have a practice of having a daily devotional life, that's something that I don't just recommend, I say you must do it for you to not have a hard heart.
那么你如果现在没有个人灵修的生活的话，我想我今天我简直不能说是一个建议，而是我说每个人必须每天要有灵修的时间。
Let's pray.
来吧，我们一起祷告。